Yes, great source. Welcome back. So, what is it that is in front of us right now? We're looking at question eight, which is a question on cubic graphs, right? So, this is a question on cubic graphs. So, let's see how we're going to go about answering this question, okay? So, yeah, cubic graphs. You learned a lot on cubic graphs. So, now here comes the question on cubic graphs. What is it that you're supposed to do to solve this question, okay? So, let's see. What is it that examiners want you to be prepared for, okay? But this is a question on cubic graphs. Looking at this question, what is it that they're saying? They're saying here the graph of g of x, which is equal to ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx, a cubic function having a y-intercept of zero. Let me see that. Yeah, the y-intercept is zero, as you can see. So meaning like that point is at the origin. That's where the graph cuts it. Okay. And then what else are you given? Okay. The y-intercept of zero. So it's drawn below. Okay. It's drawn below. And then the x coordinates of the turning point of G are, okay, we have the x coordinates, we're given the x coordinates there, which is negative one and two, right? So those are the x coordinates of G. And what is it that they want us to calculate? Now, for which values of x will G increase? So for which values of x will g increase? So that's the question that they presented with there, right? So let's see how do we go about answering a question of this nature. Now, we'll write our nature, right? Let me see if our nature, and then it so happened that this is the origin. Yes, that's the origin there. So the graph is like this, and then these are our turning points. Obviously, this is going to be the negative one. And then obviously this one is going to be two, right? Now they're asking us on 8.1 there, for which values of x will they increase, right? Where is it increasing? So let's see. You see, where is it going up? Where is the graph going up? So you see, it's from here, right? This curve is going up from here. Up to here, right, where the graph is going up. What is the value of x here? The value of x here is negative one, right? And the value of x here is two. So you can see that the value of x where the graph is going up, it lies between like negative one and two, right? That is where the values lie. So what are you going to say? The fact that it lies in between, x must be less than two, but it must be greater than negative one. So that's what you're going to say there. X must be less than two, but it must be greater than negative one. So that's how you go about it. That's how you go about answering this type of question. As you can see, this is where the function is going up. Okay. This is about answering this question. Okay. But then let me just write it down, because the way I've put it there, it might be a problem to some people. Okay. So X is less the solution to that question. So moving on. Yeah, I'll need another page. So let me just insert a page before I forget. Moving on. So we see that here, what is it that we have? Let's see. Write down the x coordinate of the point of inflection of G, right? They want us to write the x coordinate of the point of inflection of G. Now, what is the point of inflection? That's where we should study it from. We have learned what is it that they mean by the point of inflection. Now they're asking of it here. What is the point of inflection? Let me check something here, because I might make a mistake of writing a page that I was supposed to write. Okay, I made a mistake. Okay, so what is the point of inflection? We learned that the point of inflection is the point wherein the curve changes its concavity, right? That is what they're asking us, point of inflection, right? So we learned that that's the point where the curve changes its concavity. So it so happened that we have this curve here on the question there, and then somewhere here, that is where the graph changes its concavity, right? this is the point. Like, look at this curve here. This curve here, let me put this one. If I close it like this, right? See, this part is facing up. This is what? This is concave up, right? But then if you close here and like, take this part here, you see, this part here is facing down, right? And the fact that it's facing down, it means what? This is concave down, right? Concave down. So where is it changing the concavity? This part here, that's where it is changing the concavity. And this point here we're given is what? As our y-intercept, which is 0 and 0, right? Ask us, write down the x-coordinate of the point of inflection. And you're saying, here, yeah, as you can see in this question, it so happened that the point of inflection, it is also the y-intercept, right? So which means the x-coordinate there is simply 0. So you must take note of things like that. I mean, yeah. So the point at which the graph changes is concavity. And yeah, let me check if the interpretation that I've given this question is the right interpretation or I'm making a mistake. Remember, mistakes are common, they're human being, right? So there we go. I want to check as to whether what I'm saying is correct or what. Or I'm making a mistake. Okay, so what is it that we have in front of us? The point where in which the graph, no, you see, this is the y-intercept, and then this is the point of inflection has to be somewhere here, right? So how do you get the point of inflection? We're looking at the fact that we're given the what, this point here and this point here, the turning point. And it so happened that the point of inflection, according to the cubic graph, it is also the midpoint of what? It's also the midpoint of this curve here, right? That's what I'm saying. It's the midpoint of this part here. So if you feel that it is the midpoint of that part there, what does that mean? For us to have the x value for this point of inflection, what are we going to do? We're simply going to, what is it? You're going to take, here you're given -1, and here you're given 2, right? So that means the x value of the point of inflection is going to be -1 + 2, right? That's where the graph changes its concavity. And with that said, what are we going to have? X is going to be -1 + 2, that's 1, which means x is going to be 1/2. So take note of things like that, you know? You don't know what it is that the examiner is going to bring, but preparing yourself on everything, that's the best thing you can do to yourself, okay? Great stuff. So moving on, let's see, what is it that we are having in front of us? We are now moving on to 8.3. And what are they asking on 8.3? Let's see what is it that they're asking us. For which values of x will g be concave down? Now we have the point of inflection, and we said that is the point in which wherein the graph changes its concavity, right? So with that said, let's see what is it that we are going to have as the values that they are requiring in this question. So this is 8.3. Our graph is like this, right? And we found the point of inflection to be what? We found it to be 1 over. This is concave. This is concave. Concave down, right? The values of x will the graph be concave down. So you see, this is where it starts, right? All the values that are going this way from this one here, they make the graph to be concave down, right? So what does that mean? You see, the arrow is facing this side, so we can just conclude that here x, it's what? Greater than 1/2. And that's how you interpret the graphs, you know? X is greater than 1/2. There you go. So these are some of the things that you are supposed to know, you know? Interpretation of graph, that's what the examiner was playing around in this question paper. And then now we are looking at 8.4. They are saying to us, if g of x is equals to -6x² plus 6x plus 12, determine the equation of g, okay? Determine the equation of g. So how are we going to go about determining the equation of g? So let's go back a little bit. Okay, so when you're looking at, when you're comparing the two, right? Let me see if I need space or I have to insert a new page. Yeah, I have to insert a new page. That's helping form. So for helping form, helping page, as you can see. So I have my new page with me now. Let's go to 8.4. So with 8.4, what are we going to do to find the graph of G? So we are given here G prime of X, right, to be negative 6X squared plus 6X plus 12, right? This is what we're given. And then what is it that we know? We know that this G of X, this G of X, we get it from G of X, right? And G of X, it was given to us as AX cubed plus BX squared plus CX, right? This is what it was given to us. So we know that this thing here, for us to get everything that is on this, it follows that G prime of X is equals to 3AX squared plus 2BX plus C, right? This is what it follows, right? So what does that mean? It means the term that you see here, right? The term that you see here, it corresponds to 2BX, and the term that you see here, it corresponds to C, okay? So if that is the case, then we can remove B and we can work out the value of C, right? So what does that mean? The value of C, okay, let's look at the value of A. We see that 3AX squared is going to be equal to negative 6X squared, right? This one here is going to take care of this, and we have here 3A is equal to negative 6, and A here is going to be what? Negative 6 divided by 3, and that makes us to have what? Makes us to have A being equal to negative 6 divided by 3, negative 6 divided by 3, that is giving us negative 2, okay? That's great. Now, we have negative 2 for that one, and then we have here 6x. So we're saying here 2bx is the same as 6x. This x is going to take care of this x, right? And then it means 2b is equal to 6, and then b is going to be equal to what? 6 divided by 2, that is what? B is equal to 3, you see? And then we're saying c equal to the value that you have there, which is 12. And the graph was g of x is equal to ax cubed, okay? Ax cubed plus bx squared plus c. So, and this makes us to have what? This makes us to have negative 2x cubed b, that is what? Let's see, b we found to be 3. So this is 3x squared plus what is c? C we found it to be 12. So then I have plus 12x. You see? So this is how our graph is. So let me just write it right here. G of x is equal to negative 2x cubed plus 3x squared plus 12x. And that's how we would have went about solving this question. So these are just tricks that you would have mastered upon learning, you know, upon solving past exam papers. That's the main reason opposed to prepare yourself using past exam papers. So that is it. Let's remember the equation of the tangent to G, that's 8.5. That is the maximum gradient. Write your answer in the form y is equals to y is equals to mx plus c. Okay, so we know that a tangent is the line that touches the graph at one point of the graph, right? So the tangent to a cubic graph is at what? It is at It's at the point of inflection, right? So 8.4, 8.5, I mean. So this is the cubic graph. The cubic graph is like this, right? So I'm saying to you here, the tangent to a cubic graph is at a point of inflection. So this is, I cannot draw it well, but then that line that touches the graph at one point. So if the tangent of a cubic graph is at a point of inflection, we have found that x here is 1/2, right? And we know that the first derivative, the gradient of a tangent is equal to the first derivative of a cubic graph, right? Which is g prime of x. And g prime of x was given to us as negative 6 plus 12, right? And what is the value here? At x equal to 1/2, that's the point of inflection. So with that being the point of inflection, then it means what? They want to substitute here to get a gradient for the graph. We want to substitute 1/2 squared and until we get the actual value for the gradient of the curve, right? So upon substitution, what do we get? Let's see. Negative 6, 1/2 squared plus 6, 1/2 plus 12. This is going to be 27/2. So this means we have our gradient less than 7/2, right? So with our gradient being 27/2, now all the equation of the state line, we know that it says what? Y is equal to mx plus c, right? This is what they want. But the most appropriate, the most useful equation is y minus y1 is equal to m x minus x1, because you see this one, you won't forget anything, you just give your answer straight away. So we need the point here, which is that point of inflection, because that's where the graph will be touching, the tangent will be touching the graph, right? And we already know the x ring of the tangent to 1/2. And we have the graph for the y here. So with us having -2, we're gonna substitute 1/2 there. We square it, we cube it, I mean, and we add to the x, which is 1/2. We square it plus 12, 1/2, and that is going to be 13/2. So we have that point there as 13/2, okay? So 13/2 here. So we know that this one here represents x. So I put something with the s 13/2 equal to the gradient. We have it as 27/2 x minus x1, that is 1/2, right? So with us having that, we are simply going to proceed with a substitution. Let me see, what is it that, okay, I need a new page. That's something I am sure. There we go. So, okay. Now, what is it that we want? We're proceeding, we're continuing with this calculation. So what is it that we have here? We're gonna have y minus 13/2 equal to 27/2 multiplied by x, that is gonna be 27/2 x, 27/2 multiplied by 1/2. What is happening here? 27/2 x here, okay. Then 27/2 multiplied by 1/2, 27/2 multiplied by 1/2. I'm just doing it for the sake of not making a mistake, but I know the answer to it. So this is minus 27/4, right? Okay, and then y is gonna be equal to 27/2 x minus 27/4, and I take this one here across, plus 13/2. What is it that I'm going to have as my final equation? I'm gonna have 27/2 x minus or plus, I'm not sure, let's just substitute. 27/4 plus 13/2, that is minus 1/4. So this is the final answer to, I mean, this is the equation to the tangent. This is the equation of the tangent, okay? And it so happened that this was the last question, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, this was the last question. So if you have done everything correctly, then you will have worked out with your 15 marks straight away. That's it for now.